So, good afternoon, everyone. The demand for minimally processed foods has led to an increase in the development of novel food processing technologies like sous-vide and pulsed electric field. But the risk and microbial risk assessment of these foods remains an important factor for the validation of these technologies. So, despite there being a wide variety of data available in the literature, it becomes difficult to draw critical conclusions due to the variation in trial designs. To achieve this risk assessment, we can take the help of predictive microbiology that quantitatively describes the microbial behavior in food using mathematical models and statistics. So this variation in inactivation and growth rate data is primarily due to uncertainty, which arises due to the lack of knowledge about the parameters due to poorly reported experimental data, and variability, which arises due to the variations in experimental conditions and protocols. So this leads to a poorly fitting model, therefore leading to inaccurate predictions by the model. So how can we tackle this problem of uncertainty and variability? And all of this data is available in the literature. How can we put it to use? So this solution is offered to us by Bayesian networks, which take into account uncertainty by using probability. There's an extensive amount of experiments present in the literature with varying pathogens and conditions. And if we consider all of that as our prior knowledge, what we get is a broad probability distribution that does not give us any valuable inference. Bayesian networks take this prior data to their advantage, perform Monte Carlo simulations, and provide us with a much more reliable and accurate posterior probability distributions around the value of interest. For this purpose, therefore, taking Listeria as an example, we want to develop models to predict its growth and inactivation using Bayesian networks. For this purpose, we have collected the inactivation data for Listeria monocytogenes and have developed a Bayesian model that describes the influence of pH and temperature on its inactivation. And we're also performing in-house experiments to validate the model. Therefore, my thesis will lead to the development of models to predict the inactivation and growth of food pathogens in food with increased accuracy and decreased uncertainty. Also, it will help in the validation of novel food processing technologies like sous-vide, and will help make better risk-informed risk management strategies to support the uptake of these new technologies. Thank you.